Welcome back to a second example of graphing the solution to a quadratic inequality. Here we have y is less than or equal to negative x squared minus 1. So we want to find the region on the coordinate plane where the coordinates of the point in the region will satisfy this inequality. But our first step is to graph y equals negative x squared minus 1. Our graph will be solid or dashed based upon the original inequality symbol. Because we have y is less than or equal to negative x squared minus 1, the points on the graph of y equals negative x squared minus 1 will satisfy this inequality, and therefore we have to make a solid graph. Again, the solid graph means that the points on the graph are part of the solution and will satisfy this inequality. If it was just y is less than negative x squared minus 1, then the graph would be dashed because the points would not satisfy the inequality. Hopefully we recognize that the graph of this parabola is the graph of y equals x squared reflected over the x-axis and shifted down 1 unit. But just in case we don't, we can always make a table of values to graph this parabola. So for example, if x is 0, y is equal to negative 0 squared minus 1, which is negative 1. Let's select x equals 2 and x equals negative 2. When x is positive 2, this is the opposite of 2 squared, or negative 4 minus 1, so that's negative 5. And then when x is negative 2, y is equal to the opposite of negative 2 squared, which is still negative 4 minus 1, so it's also equal to negative 5. These three points should be enough to make a nice graph. We have a y-intercept of 0, negative 1, and then we have the points 2, negative 5, and negative 2, negative 5. Now we can graph the parabola, but again, the graph is going to be solid, so it'll look something like this. Now we need to determine if we're going to shade inside the parabola in this region here, or outside the parabola or this region here. To do this, we'll select a test point. The easiest test point to select is the origin, as long as it's not on the graph, which it's not. The origin has coordinates 0, 0. So we'll test to see if these coordinates satisfy the inequality. If they do satisfy the inequality, we'll shade the same region the point is in. And if the point doesn't satisfy the inequality, we'll shade the region the point is not in. So we'll substitute 0 for x and 0 for y into the original inequality. So we would have 0 is less than or equal to negative 0 squared minus 1. This is 0 is less than or equal to negative 1. And this is false because on the number line, 0 is to the right of negative 1. So 0 is greater than negative 1. So if this is false, we tested the point in this region here. So because this was false, we shade the region this point is not in, which would be the region inside the parabola, or this region down here. So what this means is the coordinates of any point in the shaded region or on the graph will satisfy this inequality, and therefore this region represents our solution. I hope this was helpful.